Hello, everybody.
Hello.
I'm Shala.
And I'm Pixel Cheesecake. Welcome back to another episode of Gaming with Shala.
Turn to side.
Today we're going to be playing a game Shala suggested. We're going to go head to head, as far as I understand.
Yep. I'm assuming this game has some head to head capabilities. To be honest, I just saw the trailer and decided I needed it in my life.
I wonder why. One could only wonder why you saw the trailer and needed to have it, like, plankton need water.
It's a mystery.
A real mystery.
Yeah, scholars couldn't interpret the signs even if they wanted to.
Straight.
And there's no point in denying it.
Just don't get into the tears of the Pokimane simping.
Pretty sure I already follow her on Twitter.
You're not giving up enough money to so she could buy a house. That's the important thing.
Yeah. Let's just start with a regular match. Wanna be friendly or competitive?
Friendly.
So they're based off the Arcana.
Nice. Tarot cards are interesting in their way. I feel like I would drain myself trying to figure it out though.
All you really need to know is that death really usually just means change. The tower means disaster.
Which? I see.
I don't.
You grab the balls and throw them, making the biggest combo you can. Match three style.
I'm gonna lose right now.
Y to grab, B to throw. I just started pushing random buttons, seeing what would work.
It's gonna take me a hot minute to get a hold of these.
You can grab as many of the same color as you want. Which, it's weird being called magical trap because you're picking them You're basically grabbing them from a long distance and throwing them back.
Yeah.
I know what someone's looking up later on this evening.
No, it...
You don't... It, you can say it, you just can't admit it on YouTube.
I've said mostly what I want on YouTube.
That's fair.
I basically have gone from
not
knowing anything to doing sick multi-chains.
Yep. You hustling me, boy?
I swear, this is literally the first time I booted up this game. I like pick one up, throw it, and then throw it back, and then it like, oh, now we're going to do a thing.
So yeah, that something tells me you're gonna unlock all the unlock all but one of the characters because you're gonna get too distracted by physics.
So much. There's so much physics going on. Easily distract me.
Did not expect that to work.
Damn it.
Can't believe I stacked it up that quickly. That was dumb luck. Or I'm just stupid good at this game.
Perhaps it's both.
Eh, probably.
Oops.
I swear, once this commission gets done that I have on the printer right now, I'm... we'll play all the available characters as we do with all the head-to-head games.
Yeah. I was like, thinking maybe if I tried a different character, I would have better luck.
Setting up combos is not easy to pull off, but if you can, that's how that works. Let gravity drop things where they lie.
So our little dudes are either running on the ceiling or they have that special reverse gravity going on here.
Ooh. Yeah. Welcome back to Conquest for Context. Get to read any fun books that thus far this year?
I've been listening to a lot of old Victorian literature. I already read Dracula for high school. And then this year it was listening to Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde, The Invisible Man, 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, While We Were the Conqueror. Invisible Man. Trying to remember books and also play the game is a little tricky for me.
Yeah, I barely got a chance to read anything recently. Oh, if you run out of quota, you automatically win. Or if you can't organize the balls.
Let's try a different move.
Sounds good.
Listening to my to all my audiobooks, I discovered the joy of free audiobooks on YouTube.
I used to have a friend who would read audiobooks. Mm-hmm. No idea where he's at. No idea what he's doing, but Aeon of Dreams. Shout hats off to you, man.
The company that I found was doing the free audiobooks is called LibriVox.
Oh, nice. Weren't they a voice acting studio at one point, or am I losing what's left in my mind?
Well, I don't really know about, like, voice acting. I just kind of was, like, looking around on YouTube for audiobooks and found them. But they do public domain ones. So
the Cthulhu ones and such.
Yeah. Well, it's basically just a bunch of like whatever, like random hodgepodge of books.
Nothing wrong with hodgepodge.
Since they're public domain, that means that they're basically free to for anybody to upload. So sometimes when I'm looking for a specific book to listen to, I'll see all these YouTube uploads, and then I'll just be recording after like video after video of the same audio.
Well, I fucked that up. Did you see the cast list for Stitch?
Yeah.
It looks... it's interesting, but I'm hoping it's not... doesn't... I'm hoping it doesn't flop.
Oh. Pretty sure they'll be just, you know, uploading it to their... to Disney Plus. So.
Well, still. Like... what are the kids saying? Like, oh, this character is this coded character, but they treat her like a real character. And it would be a shame if she was treated like a person with this condition rather than this condition who just so happens to be a person. Does that make sense?
I think so. Assume you mean that some people say that Lilo is like autistic.
That's what people are saying, but and I do see it. It's just it doesn't need to be brought up. It's just the way things are. When you and your friend pick the same character in a fighting game. Sorry. I just had to meme the shit out of that real quick.
I think when it comes to like autistic characters, I think the usually the best portrayals of characters with it tend to come from characters that weren't like really meant to.
Like she was just a. Lilo was just a loner with trauma, and Stitch was an alien that was mistaken for a dog.
Yeah.
Technically, Stitch was sentient, so buying him and treating him like a pet was technically slavery.
Well, not that they could have known.
After the big alien ship says, oh, this one's sentient. No. Oops. My bad. Like, you could be in the family dog or whatever. Well, I'm just hoping it turns out good, because for the intellectual property's sake, more than anything else.
But I wanted to hold my breath. I mean, they could have had Ving Rhames be Cobra Bubbles, but they just replacing him with some
at least it's not like Sam L. Jackson or something.
Yeah, seeing how that movie's developing, I have no doubt we aren't getting the one lifeguard character.
David?
No, the one character without a name.
The overweight tourist who really loves mint chocolate chip ice cream.
No, the sexy lifeguard lady.
They're probably gonna use a real native.
When it's done, I'll.
Oh, I know who you're talking about.
Seconds.
Did I just clear the board? We made short rounds of these.
Yeah.
The lifeguard who gives Nani the job. We're gonna get her. She's gonna be a native, apparently. I'm thinking. I'm just wondering if they're gonna CGI in Pudge the Fish. Did you know there's actually a fish in Hawaiian mythology that controls the weather?
I do. I think we've seen the...
Remember, the same, friends don't let friends eat friends. That's cannibalism.
Okay, but what if when we say eat, we mean another thing?
Oh dear God. Wouldst thou peek a gander under my frock? Sure. Hey, she wanted me to put a goose down her pants. Not what that means. Season 1 Family Guy was accidentally the most hilarious.
The jokes that, like, really have stood out the best are the ones that are...
Classically...
Like, so innocent. Subtle. You could, put them in a kid's cartoon.
Hey, what do you name your bar in a DC comic universe? Steaming Load. I'd like my Emmy now, please.
Think of stuff like so.
GG's. We currently have the length of maybe a JoJo episode?
Well, most anime episodes are usually like 24 minutes. Let's try Clodagh Crush. It's either 50 or 300.
300 might last 2 minutes.
Joke. There's a message in my cereal. It says, ooh.
Peter, those are Cheerios. They hit the nerve to call me stupid. You did mistake alphabets and Cheerios the one time. I see how it do. Well, I played myself, I think. No, I didn't. In hindsight, I thought the round was going to last a little longer. Unless I'm stupid good at these types of games.
You seem to be very good at beating me in puzzle games like this.
But put a real puzzle in front of me, like Amanda the Adventurer. I'm confused as all anything. Like, I see the tools in front of me. I think I know what I have to do, but...
of those videos, it's a team effort.
But to be fair, the one thing did glitch, so that...
Looked into some of the stuff, I think the game thought it gave us one tape while giving us the other. I think that might have even lasted a minute. Almost two.
Good to know I can last 2 minutes. Ugh. Okay, that was dumb, and I apologize for that.
I think we both know somebody who knows you could last more than two.
Babe. My God. I love my fiance so much. I call him babe.
Yeah.
And that's been fun. Can you believe we've been together for over a year? He and I? We're gonna be like this big gaming grab shit off itch.io and run with it so fast and so far. That people are gonna look back into our old videos. How did they get so popular? And they'll see this video and like, he had a fiance in 2023, and he was working on buying a house. How could he do that with the economy? And the answer is, I still have no idea how this is all working out. It's just been blind luck and a lot more research than I initially anticipated.
We'll just be watching these videos like, oh yeah, I can totally see which one, I can totally tell which one did X thing.
Justice prevails, I think. Was that justice?
I think so.
Cool.
One second. been a while since we last recorded, so there's some good news for us to talk about.
Let's hear it.
With the one I'm very interested in is that Blizzard put out that like has basically eroded so much like trust in me that whenever I hear that they have a like new character that's like some kind of progressive announcement, the thought isn't that's good. It's okay, what are you trying to hide now?
Yep.
They announced a new character called Life Weaver as a way to like hide the way they're treating like I think it was like union stuff.
Oh my god. Hello.
How you doing?
I'm good.
We're recording right now.
Alright.
Oh, you're recording?
It's all good.
I'm sorry.
No problem. Welcome my mom to as a guest on the show.
Hello.
I picked up pizza from Maggio's. I thought they'd deliver it here, but I drove to get it. No worries.
Thank you.
Not a problem. I said I would treat him to Maggio's at but the one days I wasn't planned on recording him, Rex, and I. Yeah, we kind of cut and run a little bit earlier than initially planned, so.
Where's Matthew?
It's down the street by the Deffert Mall.
Oh.
You know where the new Wawa is? It's across the street from that.
Oh, and that big shop.
Yep. I'm definitely not winning this one either.
There's a way you can get through.
Not when you have 20, when I have 24 and you have 3.
Fair enough. You are playing well, good, now that you know the button controls.
All two of them.
I'm sure you figured out the one strategy, though.
I have a strategy, but it hasn't exactly gotten me any wins yet.
You let things stack on top of each other in a way where other things will fall down around them and just pile up.
Is a joke?
Absolutely, go for it.
Okay. How do you tell who the blind guy is on the nudist beach?
Oh.
It's not hard.
Thank you for the joke.
Dancing Beach is like a really chill vacation spot.
What beach?
Gunnison Beach. It's up in North Jersey.
Is that a nudist beach?
Yes.
Oh. So you've been there?
Yep. got dunked on.
Okay, if I release the beast?
Yes.
Okay.
The beast being our pet.
Burb.
Burb. It's all squawking and biting me.
You're gonna have the injuries of JonTron at that point.
We basically decided that until her behavior gets better, that we're just gonna not have any interactions.
Don't you have to socialize birds not to bite or scratch or what have you?
I think birds are just assholes.
Well, you're not wrong, but...
Cause it's, you know, my mom's been, trying her best to get her to stop, and, like, yesterday she was, cleaning up after, you know, the... Well, a couple of days ago, she was cleaning up after my nieces have been here, and she was like, she got the broom to sweep up all, like, the kinetic sand.
Yep.
And apparently at some point, someone, like, hit our bird, because our bird's been, like, through multiple homes, and they hit her. At some point, she was, like, hit with a broom, and whenever she, like, sees a broom, she goes, like, berserk, and it, like, biting whoever has the broom, so she was biting my mom. It's like...
GG.
Finally, a mode I can win.
I thought you were winning from the visuals. The music's really fun, too.
But,
Where's Charlie Sheen's original album? That's what I call winning.
With these visuals, isn't everybody winning?
So, breaking the special tokens is a good.
Yes.
Nice. I don't think I'm... I think you're doing it a little bit... Magic dropping a little bit more efficiently than I am.
Play a little risky because I had one of the like arcana things, and and I threw it up, and it just wouldn't cause the thing to pop.
So, do you think the Speedwagon Foundation is just an extension of the SCP Foundation?
How can you be sure the Speedwagon Foundation didn't start first?
Really? That was a close one.
You can hear how loud a terrible bird is.
Remember, birds are just dinosaurs that were hyper-miniaturized by evolution.
The bird group my mom's a part of refers to their birds as dinosaurs.
I saw it. There's a style of writing that you probably heard of. Basically, where people space their words and letters weirdly.
Mm-hmm.
To make it unintentionally hilarious.
Yeah.
Like, Yoshi the dinosaur can become Yo Shit He Dinosaur. Why am I so good at these games? Well, you're kind of distracted by the visuals, aren't you?
Yeah.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how distracted are you?
At least an 8.
So yes is definitely an acceptable answer. I think we can call this one here. Thank you for watching Magical Drop 4.
6.
There have been 6 of these?
Yep.
Wow. Hats off to you, Japan. You really know how to... L-U-D-E. Shala's taking a second to figure that out. I've been Pixel Cheesecake. And we are rapidly approaching a location. Not gonna say where or what, but for now, bye-bye.
Bye-bye now.